peculiar incidents happening that you thought were just coincidences. Such as the same person crossing your path repeatedly.
Cuando un cristiano salvo pasa por su frente constantemente.
Or maybe seeing a license plate
o de una tablilla de un carro
from another state
de otro estado
at odd times.
En diferentes tiempos.
Well, how many know
¿cuántos saben?
There are no such thing as coincidences
que no hay tal cosa como coincidencias
in the kingdom of God.
En el reino de Dios.
One way that God speaks to his creation
una manera que Dios habla a su creación
is through signs.
Es por señales.
As long as our heart's desire is to follow God's path for our life,
mientras el deseo de nuestro corazón seguir en los pasos del Señor,
we shouldn't worry about being deceived.
No debemos estar preocupados en que seamos engañados.
God will never lead us to do anything
Dios no nos va a guiar a hacer nada
that goes against his word.
Que vaya en contra de su palabra.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
1 John chapter 4, verse 6.
Primera de Juan 4, 6.
You know the spirit of truth.
Sabe el espíritu de la verdad
and spirit of error.
Y el espíritu de error.
God does use signs
Dios sí usa señales
to get our attention.
Para coger nuestra atención.
God has often used signs to confirm direction in my own life.
Yo muchas veces he usado señales para confirmar su dirección en mi vida.
That's why I call my ministry Signs and Wonders.
Por eso que yo llamo mi ministerio Señales y Maravillas.
Back in 1996,
en el 1996,
I was working for the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association.
Estaba trabajando para la organización de Billy Graham.
One day after a church service,
un día después del servicio,
this was on a Saturday night,
esto fue sábado por la noche,
I went out to eat with a friend of mine named Nancy,
fui a comer con una amiga mía llamada Nancy,
who I often did evangelism with.
Que muchas veces hacía trabajo personal con ella.
And while we were eating dinner,
mientras estaba comiendo comida,
Nancy told me,
Nancy me dice,
that God wanted her to go to Toronto.
Que Dios quería que ella fuera a Toronto, Canadá.
Back then there was a move of God happening.
En eso entonces había un movimiento del Señor.
At a church called Toronto Airport Christian Fellowship.
En una iglesia en Toronto.
The move of God that was often called the Toronto Blessing.
En aquellos tiempos, el movimiento ese se llamaba el movimiento de las bendiciones de Dios.
How many familiar with that?
¿Cuántos conocido eso?
Okay. Well, I merely suggested to Nancy,
solamente le dije a Nancy
that maybe we could drive there together.
Que había la posibilidad que fuéramos guiando ambos.
And cut down on travel expenses.
Y así podíamos cortar los gastos.
Well, the next day,
día,
it was a late Sunday afternoon.
Era tarde el domingo.
I went back to church.
Vuelvo a la iglesia.
Before the evening service,
antes del culto por la noche,
I went to a class called prayer school.
Fui a una clase que se llamaba.
And while I was listening to the instructor,
y mientras yo escuchaba el instructor o el maestro,
Holy Spirit spoke to my heart.
El Espíritu Santo me habló a mi corazón.
He said he wanted me to go to Toronto the following month.
Él quería que yo fuera a Toronto el mes que viene.
Which would have been August of
1996.
Well, at first I questioned this being God's direction.
Pero primero yo cuestioné esta.
Because I just took a vacation a couple months before.
Porque había cogido vacaciones unos cuantos meses anterior.
And I thought this is too soon to be asking for time off again.
Esto es muy temprano para estar pidiendo tiempo fuera para salir otra vez.
Well, after prayer school was over,
después que esta clase se terminó,
I was walking through the lobby at my church,
voy andando por el pasillo de la iglesia,
and I saw a couple I knew
y vi una pareja que yo conocía,
that made frequent trips to Toronto.
Que hacían este viaje de frecuencia a Toronto.
So I asked them if they'd been there recently.
Y le pregunté si habían estado ahí recientemente.
And they mentioned that Rodney Howard Brown,
y mencionaron este hombre,
would be doing meetings in Toronto in August.
Que iba a tener una campaña en agosto.
Then I went into the church sanctuary.
Entonces fui al santuario.
And there was a song playing on the sound system.
Y había un himno cantándose, tocándose en el.
That I recognized.
Que yo reconocí.
It was called Sweet Wind.
Y se llamaba Dulce Viento.
It was from a Vineyard Music CD.
Y era un CD
that I knew it was recorded at that church in Toronto. I'm getting goosebumps right now as I'm sharing this. Can you recognize God was using divine science to confirm that? He gave me more the next 3 days. I still was reluctant to ask for time off again. But I remember the following Wednesday night, just before church started, I was talking to a friend of mine named Wendy about thinking about going to Toronto again. So I've been there once before. Wendy showed me a penny that she had found. A Canadian penny.
De Canadá.
From 1925.
Wow.
And then it occurred to me, I was thinking of going to Toronto from the 19th to the 25th. And then during the service, the pastor that was ministering, he was reading an article about a church that was experiencing revival. The church was in Seattle, but this move of God was being compared
pero este movimiento de Dios se estaba comparando
to the Toronto blessing.
Con la bendiciones que estaba recibiendo en Toronto.
As soon as the pastor spoke those words,
enseguida que el pastor habló esa palabra,
I looked over at Wendy.
Yo miré a Wendy.
She was sitting on the other side of the sanctuary. She was looking at me,
y ella lo mira a él,
smiling,
y se está sonriendo,
nodding her head.
Y dándole así señal.
It was obviously a confirming
sign. Ella sabía que era la prueba de que él tenía que salir.
So the next morning,
la próxima mañana,
I came into work,
voy a trabajar,
started filling out a time off request.
Voy a estar llenando la solicitud para el tiempo que necesitaba.
And while I was doing that,
y mientras estoy haciendo eso,
Holy Spirit spoke to me again.
El Espíritu Santo me habla,
said, you'll have to resign from your job to make this trip.
Tienes que dejar el trabajo completamente para poder hacer ese viaje.
I initially thought this was the devil harassing me. So I ignored the thought. Submitted in my time off request. Following Monday, I was informed that my time off request was denied. So eventually I went back to my supervisor. And I told him, I strongly believe God wants me going to Toronto. And if it means having to leave my job, I'm prepared to do that. Later I was told, I had 2 days to change my mind. Well, I had an important decision to make.
Yo tenía una decisión importante que hacer.
Was I going to obey God?
Iba a obedecer a Dios.
Or obey man?
O obedecer al hombre.
Well, I wanted to make sure I left there on good terms.
Pero yo quería salir en buenas condiciones.
So I decided to have a talk with my supervisor's supervisor.
Pues decidí de hablar con el supervisor de mi supervisor.
And he told me,
y él me dijo,
we're sorry to see you leave,
vas,
but if God's telling you to do something,
you
and so a week later,
tarde,
I put in
otra vez,
what I thought would be my last week at Billy Graham. Now when people at my church found out about my pending resignation, some of them were questioning whether I was hearing from God. Well, God continued to use confirming signs.
Pero Dios siguió usando señales confirmando.
After the following Wednesday night service,
hasta el próximo miércoles del servicio, después de ese servicio,
I was ushering that night.
Yo era ujier ese día.
At the end of the service,
al final del servicio,
I went up to the altar to receive prayer.
Yo fui al altar para que oraran por mí.
Soon as I raised my hands,
enseguida que levanté mi mano,
guess what I heard on the sound system?
Que, mire, no le digo qué es porque
sweet wind.
Lo que yo oí en el himno era otra vez dulce sueño.
From that Toronto CD.
No sueño. Del CD de Toronto.
Similar thing happened the following Sunday. Similar thing happened the following Sunday.
Lo mismo le pasó el próximo domingo.
Some friends invited me to sit up front with them.
Algunos amigos me invitaron a sentarme al frente con ellos.
After I placed my Bible on the chair,
después que puse mi Biblia en la silla,
Sweet Wind came on the sound system.
El mismo himno volvió otra vez.
And let me clarify, the sound man did not know anything about this.
Y quiero decirle, hermano, que el hombre que estaba encargado del sistema no sabía nada de esto.
The following Saturday,
el próximo sábado,
on my way to Toronto,
en mi camino para Toronto,
I was driving through Wisconsin.
Iba por Wisconsin.
Nancy was riding with me.
Nancy iba conmigo.
She wanted to stop at McDonald's.
Ella quería ir a McDonald's.
I waited outside
because
I was fasting at the time. When Nancy came back outside,
Nancy regresó,
she said she heard a boy holler in there.
Dice que yo un niño gritar ahí.
Look, I found a Canadian penny.
Mi